Just because something's pretty and you want it doesn't mean that you should take it home.
Brand new at 7 on ABC 7, a sand dollar scandal. Let's take you through it. We can tell you it started when an ABC 7 viewer reached out to us.
He said he had spotted people taking sand dollars and other sea life off the beach while they're still alive. So now he's trying to get the word out, reminding people if you do that, you could face a hefty fine.
We sent ABC 7 Simone Cucurillo to the beach today for our cover story, but it turns out she discovered something else you may not know.
Here at Lighthouse Beach on Sanibel Island, there's no shortage of shells. But what most people don't realize is that live shelling is prohibited, meaning before you pick up a sand dollar to take home with you, you should double check to make sure it's not alive.
The beauty of the beach.
It's gorgeous, beautiful.
Something tourists travel hundreds of miles to see and often end up bringing a piece of paradise home with them.
They have a pretty wide variety of seashells.
But tonight, experts and animal lovers are warning of the dangers of taking live creatures away from their natural habitat and into your home.
You can't take home any live mollusk or echinoderm from our beaches.
Lee Gay from the Bailey Matthews National Shell Museum says in Lee County, if you're caught taking a live creature like a sand dollar, you could face hefty fines and even jail time.
Just because these animals aren't cute and fluffy like the animals we usually care about doesn't mean that they deserve any less respect.
Some people on the beach we talked to today had no idea scooping up a sand dollar could come with such a big consequence.
I luckily found one the other day and put it back, but I wouldn't have known not to take it.
It's okay to admire things, but just leave it in its habitat and just appreciate the beauty.
A reminder experts like Lee say is key to be aware of.
If we collect live animals, then we're eventually not going to have any live animals left.
In order to protect the beauty at the beach that so many come to see.
The whole reason you come here is to admire the beauty. If you're taking all of it away, what's left? When it comes to the live shelling policy here on Sanibel Island, there are a bunch of codes and regulations, both for the island and for Lee County. To check out this full list, we'll put it on our ABC 7 news app. I'm reporting on Sanibel Island today. Simone Cucurillo, ABC 7.
So how do you tell the difference between a live sand dollar and a dead one? Well, the dead ones are white, the ones you would see on a store shelf or something. The live ones are usually brown. They look kind of wet and they may have some prickly things around them.